I think what Hodge put me on to was the vector bundles and characteristic classes. I read Chern's papers on Chern classes, and there was some work which Allendoerfer and Weil had done. And so he gave me that direction, and that got me started on characteristic classes and vector bundles. There was then, secondly, we had a visiting American, a chap called Newton Hawley, who spent a sabbatical when my first year, and I got to know him quite well and were friendly with him. And he was just beginning to work on vector bundles, analytical vector bundles. But it was rather ironical, actually. It was rather delicate, because what happened was that he'd written a paper, which had published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, on analytical vector bundles. And he explained this paper to me, and we discussed it. And then I started working on vector bundles and algebraic geometry. And I soon realized that actually his paper was all wrong. Fundamental error. It was absolutely, totally fundamental. He claimed that the topological classification worked in the analytical case, and it was all the jumps that we know about didn't have. So it was my first paper. It was a bit embarrassing. I had to sort of have a little appendix pointing out this thing, and Hodge told me I had to turn it down a little bit, you know. So it was a bit, I got to know friendly with him, and he liked it. You know, we got on very well. But and my introduction was this slightly bizarre that he introduced me a bit to the subject, and I discovered that he'd made this fundamental error, and that helped me get started. that was one side. Then, of course, the second side direction, that was the vector bundle side. Then all the stuff to do with sheaf cohomology, well, that was being published at that time all in the Contrat en Deux Notes in Paris. And I don't quite know how, but I mean, I got onto that. And I would go into the library every week, and there'd be another note by Carter and Serre and all these people explaining all this sheaf cohomology, which I sort of, you know, picked up. And I discussed it with Hodge. He was interested to it, but he didn't really know, understand it that well, I think. And the topologists didn't really know about it here. But I mean, I wrote my, you know, the Smith's Prize essays that you submit in your first year. Well, my Smith's Prize essay, which so it's done in the first year really, was about the application of sheaf cohomology to the classification of real surfaces. So I obviously, and I'd seen at that stage a letter that Sarah had written about the Riemann-Roch theorem, which was going around informally. So in that first year, I must have picked up all about sheaf cohomology and the Cordaro-Spencer work. Were all coming in pretty fast. And of course, by the time of the International Congress in Amsterdam in 54, which was my end of my second term as a research student, by that time, you know, say I got the Fields Medal and Cordaro was, and so Cordaro also. And Hodge had been over to Princeton a little bit before that and met Cordaro and Spencer. So I pretty rapidly fully integrated into the sort of information network about these things. But I think it just, you know, it was good timing. The time I started, these things were just taking off. And with a bit of help from Hodge and a bit of good fortune in the library, I sort of found out this was the exciting thing to learn about. And then subsequently I met Hitchin and others. But the early, and Hawley was helped a bit.